Hello students, today we are going to discuss the topic food and its components. So as we have discussed in the earlier video when we discussed the question paper, that national means come merit scholarship test will be having physics, chemistry and biology topics. So under biology topic, this is the first topic, food and its components. So we all know that food is very essential, or it is the basic need for any living organisms. We know the basic needs of any living organism are air, water and food. For any living organism, the minimum basic needs are air, water and food. So under these basic needs, the first topic we are going to discuss is food and its components. So we know that all living organisms, they need food. So we eat food to get energy, right? And it helps us for the growth. We eat food to get the energy and for the growth, and it also keeps our body warm. It keeps our body warm, and it also heals the injured parts. It also heals the injured parts. It also, food, whatever we are going to eat, it protects us from diseases and keeps us healthy. To be healthy, we have to eat the food. So we have seen that all living organisms eat food. By eating the food, we are going to get the energy, and the growth will take place with the help of food. And the body will be warm, and it heals the injured parts of the body. And also by taking the food, it protects us from diseases and we'll be healthy. We will be healthy. So from where we are getting this food? So food is obtained. Food is obtained from both plants and also animals. Food is obtained from plants and animals. So as we know, whatever the food we are taking, like rice, dal, fruits, vegetables, so like this we are going to obtain this from the plant. So the foods which we are obtaining from the animals are milk, egg, meat, yes, honey. Like this, we are going to obtain different food items from the animals also. Now we'll see what are the different food components present in the food. So we eat different food items which are obtained from plants also and animals also. So what are the components present in that food items? Yes. So here the different components present in the food are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. So these are the different food components present in the food what we are eating every day. So these food components, they are also called as nutrients. So these food components which are present in the food, they are called as the nutrients. So each one of them we will see now. So firstly we will see the carbohydrates. So here the carbohydrates, it is the energy giving. So we get energy when we consume the carbohydrate rich food. Energy giving. So what are the different food items we get the carbohydrates from? So here the carbohydrates, they are present in the rice, yes, rotis. So from the flour, jawar, yes, like this, and some of the vegetables such as potato, etc. So the carbohydrate rich foods, when we are eating, we are going to get the energy. Next we'll see proteins. Proteins are the body building, so they build up the body. Protein rich food. As proteins help in the body growth and repair. Body growth and repair. Hence they are known as body building. So we are going to obtain these proteins from the food, milk, eggs, meat and dals, different types of dals also, that is pulses, fish. So these are the energy, body building, that is proteins we are going to obtain from this food items, etc. So next one is fats. Fats also give us energy. Fats also give us energy. These are mostly present in the milk products. Fats are present mainly in the milk products, butter, ghee, curd, and also egg yolk. The yellow color part of the egg, it contains high fat, egg yolk, yes. And next, cooking oils. Oils also, they are rich in fats. So these are the different food items where we can get the fats. So fats are also energy giving food component. Next we'll see. Next food component is vitamins. So vitamins, they are required, very small quantity of it is required by the body. Very small quantity is required by the body. But when they are deficient, when we are not taking vitamins in our diet, we are going to suffer with diseases. We are going to suffer with the diseases. So we know our body requires different type of vitamins. We will see what are they. We have two types of vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. So under fat soluble vitamin, they are A, D, E and K. These four vitamins, they are the fat soluble vitamins, and water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and vitamin C. These two are the water soluble vitamins. So now we'll see vitamins. They are of two types. Fat soluble vitamins are vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K. And water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and vitamin C. So these vitamins, they are obtained from different type of vegetables and fruits we eat. From the vegetables and fruits, leafy vegetables and more different vegetables, when we eat, we are going to obtain these vitamins. Next is minerals. Minerals are also required in very small quantity by our body, but when they are not fulfilled by our body by the food intake, we also suffer from different types of diseases. So different type of vitamins required by our body minerals by our body are iron, iodine, right, calcium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, yes, etc. These are the very small quantity required minerals by our body. If you are not taking these minerals into our body, then we will be suffering from the different types of diseases. So we have to take these vitamins and minerals also by consuming different food items. These are also we can obtain from the different types of vegetables and fruits. Next component, it is not a component but it is very essential for our body in our food, that is roughages. Roughages, they are also known as dietary fibers. Dietary fibers. So this is not a food exactly, but it is the if we consume this, then it helps in the cleaning our body. It helps in the cleaning our body, that is bowel movement. Whatever the undigested food, it has to be removed from our body. It adds to the bulk of our body. So these roughages, they are obtained from the vegetables and fruits. So by consuming the roughages in our diet, it prevents the constipation problem. It prevents the constipation problem in our body. Next one is water. Water is the very essential constituent. It is a very important constituent of all body cells. So water is required for all the biological processes in our body. All the biological processes taking place in our body, they need water. So we have to drink sufficient amount of water. Water makes the movement of food easily in the food pipe. It helps in the digestion of the food. So whatever the food we are eating, it enters from the food pipe into the intestine and helps in the digestion process. So we have to drink plenty of water. Next, so all these food components which we have studied till now, they makes up the balanced diet. So all the food components should be present in our diet. So all the food components in equal proportion, if they are consumed in our diet regularly, then it is called as the balanced diet. It is called as the balanced diet. So if at all any person is not taking the balanced diet, they are going to suffer from different deficiencies. So they will be undernourished. So to be healthy, we have to take balanced diet every day. Next one is the founder. Question mostly they may be asking in NMMS. The founder of modern science of nutrition. The founder of modern science of nutrition is lavished. Okay children, in the next video I'll be explaining in detail about vitamins and their deficiencies and their diseases. So keep watching for the next videos. Thank you.